Hey, I'm Dusty, friends call me Moose. I'm the dude behind CameraTips.com. And in this video, I wanna share with you my favorite custom in-camera settings that make using the Sony A6000 so much better. Now, before we get started, I wanna mention down in the description below, I have a table of contents. So you can go forward or backward as you pause the video, and you can use that as a reference while you're setting up the camera. Now, before we dive into the settings, let's go ahead and reset everything back to default so that if there are any settings that you've already inputted, they'll be cleared out and we'll have a blank slate to work with. So to do that, we'll jump into the menu and we're gonna go over to the sixth tab and then over to the sixth page, down to setting reset, camera settings reset, and then hit okay. Now, the first thing that I want to show you is something that is a common complaint with the A6000, and that is the brightness of the monitor. Now, one of the things that you may notice is when shooting outside and looking at the LCD screen, it can be really washed out. So there is a way to increase the brightness, and I actually came across sort of a little trick that's just buried and hard to find that makes things ever so slightly more brighter. So if we jump into the menu, we will see an option here on the sixth tab over on page number one, we'll see monitor brightness. Now here, most people will come down to this option here and increase the brightness two clicks to +2. Now I've noticed that there's this option here, and if we click on that, we'll see this secondary option called sunny weather. Now it's hard to see on screen, but if you do it yourself, you'll actually see the screen increase even more than that +2 setting. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that now. All right, now I wanna show you a way to keep the camera on and preventing it from turning off. By default, after 60 seconds of not using the camera will boot down. And this can be kind of frustrating if you're, you know, out taking pictures and you have it slung around your neck. You go to bring up the camera to take a photo and you realize the camera's off and you have to wait a few seconds for it to boot up. And by then you can miss the shot. So I like forcing the camera to stay on as long as possible and ensure that I can use my camera and not have to wait for anything to turn back on. So let's jump back into the menu and we're gonna go over to the sixth tab and we're gonna go over to page two and then down to power save start time. And then we're gonna set this option to 30 minutes. All right, now I wanna talk to you about custom buttons. One of the things that I love about this camera is the ability to assign buttons to features that are buried inside the menu. It makes it so much easier just to press a button to pull that feature that you always use and not have to fumble through a bunch of pages and tabs. Now, what's extra nice is we have two dedicated custom buttons. We have one on top of the camera labeled C1, and then we have another one on the back of the camera labeled C2. So what by default, the C1 button is set to focus mode. And I actually find this really helpful. It's one of the modes that I often change depending on the scenario that I'm in. And the focus mode is basically just telling the camera, hey, let's focus one time or let's focus continuously. What I like to do with the C2 button is set that to focus area, and that helps us control the focus points. So let me go ahead and show you how to do that. If we jump back into the menu, we're gonna go over to tab number two, and then we're gonna go over to page number six. And we're gonna see this option here called custom key settings. So let's go ahead and enter into that. And then here you'll see two custom buttons. We have custom button one, which is set to focus mode, and then we have custom button two, which is currently set to an in-camera guide, kind of like a manual. So let's go ahead and change this to focus area. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that. And then we're gonna come all the way up here to focus area and select that. So now when I go to take a photo, I can quickly adjust my focus mode by pressing C1 and then selecting which focus mode I want. We'll go with continuous. And then on the back of the camera, I can press C2. And that will bring up our focus area. And I can set this to, let's say, flexible spot. And then I can focus on my subject and then take the shot. Now, another thing that you can customize that I find really helpful beyond these two custom buttons is the function menu. So on the back of the camera, if you press the FN button, This brings up sort of a quick menu where you can access features and functions again that are commonly accessed for everyday photos. Now here you'll see that there are a bunch of tabs. We have a row at the top and a row at the bottom, and all of these tabs can be customized by you. So what we'll do is we'll go back into the menu, tab 2, page 6, and then we're going to select function menu set. And you'll see here at the very top 1 and 2. So this is the first row, this is the second row, and then these are all the tabs. So if, for instance, I wanted to set my lower row far right hand tab to something in the menu, I could go ahead and select 2 function lower 6. And I'm gonna go ahead and set this to smile and face detection. So now if I press the function button, I can bring up the function menu, and you'll see at this second row all the way over to the far right, it's now smile face detection. So I can turn this option on, and now I have a face detection box around my subject. Next to face detection, eye autofocus is probably my favorite feature on the Sony a6000. What eye autofocus does is it looks for the subject's eye and it puts a little focus frame around it and ensure that their eyes come out tack sharp. Now, there is one caveat to this, is that we have to make sure that the focus mode is set to AFS. It will unfortunately not work in continuous. So before we set everything up, let's go ahead and change our focus mode. I'm gonna go ahead and press the C1 button on top of the camera. I'm gonna set this to AFS. Now let's jump into the menu, and we're going to go back to where we were before, second tab, page 6, down to custom key settings. And then we're going to set our AEL button, and we're going to change that to eye autofocus. On the back of the camera, you'll see a button labeled AEL. And what we want to do there is press and hold that button when pointing it at our subject. And we're going to get that little focus box appear around their eyes. And you'll see right there, it focused right on the subject's eyes, and I can go ahead and press the shutter down and then take the shot. All right, now I want to show you something crazy. So the photo that I just took, I took it in landscape or horizontal orientation. However, when I go to play back the image, you'll see that now the image is cropped in and vertical. Like, what the heck is going on? This is Sony's intelligent way of cropping our photos for us. And it was literally driving me nuts trying to figure out, why are my images not the way I took them? And so this leads us to the next thing that we want to customize, and that is to turn this option off. So to do that, we're going to jump into the menu, and we're gonna go over to tab number 1, page number 6. And then we're gonna come down to auto object framing. And we're gonna turn this from auto to off. So now when I go to take a photo, I fully press the shutter and then bam, I actually have the photo that I meant to take. Now, speaking of vertical images, one of the things that I like to change when playing back images is the ability for vertical images to not appear straight up and down, but to lay flat so that they appear larger on screen. Let me go ahead and demonstrate. So if I play back a most recent image here, this vertical image, you'll see that there are black bars on either side. And while you may be viewing this on a larger screen, on this very tiny LCD screen, when you see an image vertically, it can appear really small and hard to tell if you got it in focus or not. And so even if you rotate the camera, it won't flip the image for you. So if we press the menu button and come over to the 5th tab, page 1, and then down to display rotation and set this to off, I'll go ahead and show you what happens. Go ahead and play back that image, and now you'll see that that image is laid down, and so I can view that image much larger on the back of the LCD screen. The last thing that I want to show you is a way to increase the video autofocus speed. Now, for most of us in everyday real world situations, we want the video autofocus to be as fast as possible. If you're an indie filmmaker and you're doing something creatively and you want the autofocus transitions to go a little bit slower, then you do have that option. But I'm going to go ahead and show you a way to speed things up. So before I do that, I'm going to show you a little example. Let me go ahead and hit record. And as I go forward and backward, you say it takes a little bit for the camera to catch up and focus on the mug. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and stop that recording, and then we're going to jump into the menu, and we're gonna come to this first tab, page number 3, And then down here, there are two options, AF drive speed and AF track duration. So we're gonna do AF track duration, set that to high, and then AF drive speed, set that to fast. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit record. And as I go forward and backward, you can see it does a much better job of focusing quickly and keeping the mug nice and sharp. Now, if you're still trying to figure this camera out, maybe you're unsure of which settings to use, I actually just released a set of really simple cheat sheets for the Sony A6000 that show you the exact settings I use for really common scenarios like portrait, sports, landscapes, and more. You can kind of think of them like recipes. I show you the shooting mode, the exposure settings like aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. I also go over the autofocus modes depending on the subject or scene. So if you're interested in checking that out, I'll put a link down in the description below. Until next time, thanks for watching. Catch you later.